Ladies and gentlemen, in the following video, we will learn how the value of duty cycle is influencing the power flow to or from the battery and investigate the operation of a buck and boost converter when duty cycle is varied over a wide range. In one of the previous videos, we explained theoretically the operation of the two quadrant buck and boost converter. In the following animation, you can see electric vehicle in different mode of operation, namely driving and regenerative braking. The voltage of the high voltage bus is 500 volt and the battery voltage is 200 volt. Inductor of the value of 500 microhenry, here is the inductor, is connected on the low voltage side for boost operation. Here the switches S1 and S2 are considered as ideal switches, but in reality they consist of active switch and antiparallel diode as explained in one of the previous videos. The switches S1 and S2 are switching complementarily with duty cycle D and 1 minus D respectively. The blue curves in the graph are showing the instantaneous values of the voltages and currents. This is the voltage and this is the current. While the red curves show the corresponding average values. Average value of the voltage, average value of the current. For us, it is interesting to see the variation of average values of current IL and V12 shown by red curves with duty cycle. Convention for direction of the current is that it is positive when it is flowing from the inductor to the battery, from the inductor to the battery. The slider here will give the instantaneous state of the switches S1 and S2. So this slider gives the instantaneous values of the switches S1 and S2. They are varying. The slider on the top is used to vary the duty cycle from 0 to 1 as shown here. We can vary duty cycle to values from 0 to 1. On the graph below, the voltage of the high voltage bus, V high voltage bus, and the battery VBAT are shown with the blue lines, while the average values of V12 is shown with the red line. And this value varies from the duty cycle. If average value of the V12 is less than VBAT, the average current IL will flow from the battery to high voltage bus and hence it will operate in driving mode. This is the driving mode at this moment. In this mode, the converter acts as a boost converter. On the other hand, if the V12 is higher than VBAT, I will set it, duty cycle, higher than 0.4, then the average current IL will flow from the high voltage bus to the battery, and hence regenerative braking will operate in buck mode. The direction of current and the power flow, both are the same, is also visible in the car on the left bottom side. It says even regenerative braking and the current direction is visible on the arrow. Now, when duty cycle of S1 is set to 0.2, let's do that, 0.2. The average current, I average, shown by dashed line, is flowing from the battery to high voltage bus. You can see the current direction from the battery to high voltage bus. Now let's see how the current and the voltage will vary when duty cycle for S1 is increased to 0.3. As it can be observed from the animation, the direction of average current remains the same, but the value is changed from minus 2000 amperes to minus 1000 ampere, while the average voltage V12 changes from 100 volt to 150 volt. As it is shown in the second and first line in the table. The power delivered is also changed from minus 400 kilowatt to minus 200 kilowatt, as shown in the last line of the table. The converter operates in a boost mode and the power in both cases is transferred from the battery to the high voltage bus since the battery voltage is more than V12 in average. When the duty cycle of S1 is further increased to 0.4, then the average voltage V12 is increased to 200 volt, and which is equal to the battery voltage. Blue and red line are coinciding, and hence the average current is 0 ampere for this duty cycle. Consequently, the power transferred is 0 watt. Important point to be noted here is that although the average value of current is 0 ampere, but the instantaneous value is not always 0 as it can be observed here. It's around 0 with some ripple. During the boost operation, actually to get the boost operation, I have to set the duty cycle back to 0.3. When we move the slider for the switches, this is the slider for the switches, when S1 is on, magnitude of the instantaneous value of the current IL is decreasing, but because of the current direction convention, it is shown increasing in negative direction in the graph. Moving the slider further turns the S2 on. The magnitude of the instantaneous value of the current starts increasing. It is shown decreasing in the graph because of the sign convention again. You can also see how the switching state of the switches S1 and S2 is changing when you move the slider. As we increase the duty cycle further to 0.5, the average voltage V12, this is the average voltage V12, is higher than the Vbat voltage, and hence the direction of the average current changes from high voltage bus to battery, from high voltage bus to battery, with average value of 1000 amperes and 200 kilowatt power is transferred. 1000 ampere is the average value, and 200 kilowatt of the power is transferred. The converter is operating in the buck mode. This is the case of regenerative braking, when the power from high voltage bus, from this bus, is used to charge the battery, as shown in the car animation in the bottom left. You can see that also the power from high voltage bus is charging the battery, and we are in the regenerative braking. During buck operation, when we move the slider for the switches, it can be observed that when S1 is on, this is the situation when S1 is on, S1 is conducting, magnitude of the instantaneous value of the current IL is increasing. Current is increasing. Moving the slider further turns the switch S2 on. The magnitude of the instantaneous value of the current starts decreasing because of the freewheeling diode. You can also see how the switching state of the switches S1 and S2 is changing when you move the slider. When we move the slider for the switches and observe when S1 is on, current is increasing, and moving the slider further when S2 is on, actually it is freewheeling diode, the current will decrease. You can also see the position of the switches S1 and S2 changing. Similarly, when duty cycle is increased to 0.7, the average current increases to 3000 amperes, and V12 average increases to 350 volt. So 3000 amperes and 350 volt, V12. Hence, the power transferred is also increased to 600 kilowatt. Of course, 600 kilowatt is way too high power. It's just for illustration that this is the possibility of the buck and boost converter. General observation is that average V12 increases as duty cycles increases from 0 to 1, and the current changes from negative to positive values. So, we have seen how the magnitude of duty cycle controls the mode of operation, direction of the current, hence the power transferred, depending on the converter mode, whether it is operating in the buck or boost operation. Thank you.